So let's continue our journey to learn NiFi. So in this session, we are going to learn about updating records of a flow file. So I have a file which is called student info. Let me clear the screen first. Okay, so as you can see, I have a file which is called student info, and I have a few column names which is called ID, name, mobile number, gender, assignment, submission status. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to read this file, and after that we are going to make some changes in some of the records. Okay, so the way to do that is the first thing which I have done is I have created a process group. So always make sure whenever you are going to make a code, you always do that inside a process group. Do not try to make any flows on the root level. By root level, what I mean is whenever you see in the breadcrumbs NiFi flow is shown, don't try to place the processes here. The first thing you should be doing is place the process group here. It is a good practice. So I have already created a process group which is called updating data example. Now I'm going to go inside this process group by selecting enter group. And here, let's say we need, okay, so we need a get file processor to read that file. And then we need update record processor. Okay, so update record processor is used to modify or perform conditional transformation on a file. And then let's add log message just for the placeholder. So I'm going to disable this one, and let's connect get file to update record and connect update record to log message for the case of success, and then we will connect again for the case of failure, so we can see two separate queues. Okay, now let's right click on the get file and change the input directory. So the file is under this directory /home/nifi admin. And the name of the CSV file is studentinfo.csv. So I'm going to paste that file here. File name here, okay. And let's change this keep source to true. We don't want our file to get deleted. And in the scheduling, let's change it to 60 seconds. Okay, so that's it here. Now let's right click on update record and select configure. And in the properties, we have record reader, we have record writer. So whenever you perform record level operation, you know there is a concept of record reader and record writer, and in that we need to provide the controller which is going to be used to perform reading and writing operation. So we have already done this many times. I'm not going to explain this again. So I have already created a CSV reader in which I have selected the properties to infer schema. So it is just going to read whatever is in the content of a file. And in the record writer, I have selected CSV record set writer. So that's it. For now, I am not going to make any changes here. Now you can see in the update record, it's complaining about it needs minimum of one record path. Okay, so by record path, what we mean is we must supply one of the column name on which we want to make changes. So the general assumption is since you are using update record processor, you must want to make changes in the existing data. That is the reason you are using update record. So you cannot just fill reader and writer properties. You need to specify one of the column and you need to apply some transformation or some update information or some logic on that. So by that, what I mean is let's read more about update record in the Apache NiFi documentation. Okay, so you can see update record as a record reader, and RecordWriter properties. Okay, so RecordReader, RecordWriter properties. And then okay, so there is not much information here on this screen. Let's go to additional details, and in the additional details you can see basically in the properties file we need to give some column name, and then we can give the value which we want to modify this column name with. Okay, so in our scenario we are not going to do this simple operation, so what we'll be doing is we'll be making use of NiFi functions. Okay, so in the Apache NiFi expression languages we have many NiFi functions, so we are going to use these functions to modify the data of the file. Okay, so first thing which I want to do is, if you see I have names, so first thing I want to do is, let's say we want to change the name from lowercase to uppercase. Okay, so you see all these names are here in the lowercase. Let's update these to uppercase. So right click on update record and select configure, and then click on plus symbol, and here you need to specify slash along with the column name which you want to modify. So I want to change name. Okay, now select OK. And now the way you write the, or you refer to the value of slash name column is, so you need to specify field dot value. Okay, so field dot value is going to be whatever value which is inside the slash name column. Okay, so now next thing which we want to do is we want to convert the name to uppercase. So for that I'm going to use NiFi functions. And we have something called toUpper. This is a function which can convert a string to uppercase. Okay. And remember these are functions, so it should always be followed by parentheses. Okay, so I'm just going to copy paste from documentation to here. So this is our expression which is going to convert name to uppercase. Okay, so field dot value is going to refer to what is the value in the name, and then toUpper is going to convert all those values to uppercase. Now let's see this in action. Let's select apply, and all the processors are ready to run. So let's select get file to start and click on refresh. Let's stop this get file so we don't read duplicate data again. Now let's select start on the update record and start this processor. Okay, you see the flow file has been moved to success relationship, and the expectation is that whatever data you see here, whatever name you see here, should have been converted to uppercase. Okay, so right click on this queue and select list queue, and then in the view content, okay, as we can see all the values of name has been changed to uppercase. You see all the names have been changed to uppercase. Now next thing, let's say what we want is, we have gender here. In the gender column we have values like male or female. So let's say we want to change, or we want to change this column from male or female to M or F. So M should be denoting male and F should be denoting female. So for that we can make use of substring function. Okay, so I'm scrolling down, and since we need the first character, so we can actually make use of this function, and we can just copy this here, and I'm going to stop this processor because we are going to make changes. and then we are going to click on plus, and this time we want to modify gender column, so it should be, so property name should be slash gender, and then select OK. And here, since we copy pasted the function from this section to here, you see by default there is file name here, but what we need is field.value, because field.value is going to refer to all the values which is under slash gender, or basically under gender column. Okay, so the way substring function works is it starts reading from zero character, or which is the first character, and then we define how many characters we want to read. So in this case we want to read one character, so it is always going to take first character from a string. So select OK and apply. This is the previous queue, so I'm going to clear the queue. And let's right click on the get file, start the processors. Let's start the update record processor. Let's click refresh. And let's stop the get file. And now in the success queue, we can see a flow file has been moved. Let's see the content of this flow file. Okay, so as you see now, gender column has been updated by first character of the value. So we had male and female, now that has been changed to M or F. Okay, now let's say we want to change all the assignment submission status from yes, wherever we see yes, we want to change it that to good. Okay, so we can make use of another function which is replace. And let's use this function. So I will close this and I'll stop this processor. Right click, go to configure. And the column in which we want to make changes is called assignment underscore submission underscore status. Click OK. And here we will use field.value again followed by colon. And the value which we want to replace is yes. And the value with which we want to replace this is good. So wherever we see yes should be replaced with good. Okay, so let's click on apply. And let's start both the processors. So we can just right click on the empty canvas and select start. It will start both the processors. And now we can see we already have a flow file moving here. So right click, let's see the content. Okay, as you see the value did not work properly because the function which we wrote, the syntax of the function is little incorrect. So we had used closing braces rather than these curly braces. Okay, so let's make changes. Let's clear the queue. We don't want to keep old data, so let's clear the queue and then stop this processor and make changes. This is the one. So we want to make changes in assignment submission status. So this one we need to change to curly braces. If you do not use function, it will assign the literal value to that column. So that's why last time the function did not work properly and the whole thing was treated as a value and it was assigned to assignment submission status. But that's not what we want. So let's start all the processors again. And click on stop. We can already see there is a flow file which has moved to success queue. And let's select view content. Okay, so this time we see wherever there was value yes, and that value has been changed to good. So this is how actually you make use of update processor along with NiFi functions to perform transformation or business rules or business logic, whatever you call it,